Hello, and welcome to the November 2012 edition of Radnor 411. My name is Jim Doling, and I will be your host. We're going to jump right in and head over to the police department, where Sergeant George Smith tells us about some of the new parking kiosks you will find in the township.
Welcome. This is a Radnor Township parking kiosk. This specific kiosk is a Parkion Strata model. This is an up-close version of the parking kiosk. There's pictograms to help you figure out what you need to do when you get before the meter. Close up, insert coin, bill, credit card, or a debit card supplied by the township. All parking kiosks are in operation from Monday through Saturday, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m., and they accept all forms of coins. This is where the bills would be placed in the machine. Credit cards and debit cards would be placed in this slot. Follow the directions in the pictogram, press the green button, take your ticket, and place it on the dashboard inside your vehicle, writing side up. Very important aspect to the parking kiosk. Coin return, and this is where your receipt would come out of the machine. Here is an example for the South Wayne lot. The time in, how much was placed, and when it expires. These tickets must be displayed face up. If you have to cancel at any time, just hit the cancel button. Your kiosks are marked with parking stickers. There are three locations, one in the South Wayne lot on South Wayne Avenue. This is looking southbound on South Wayne Avenue towards the kiosk, across the street view from the Radnor Middle School, and a close-up view. The second location is the Bellevue lot, also known as the AT&T lot. There are two parking kiosks in this lot, one in the east end and one in the west end. This is a close-up version of the west end view. This is the east end. Both are ADA compliant, so wheelchairs can access the port. This is the Waynewood Luella lot. This lot has one kiosk that services two lots. It's placed in the midpoint of the lots. Here's a close-up version, and there's a sign indicating where it is. The kiosk system is for the flexibility of patrons, employees, and those that are trafficking through Radnor Township. We hope this tutorial was informational and of a benefit to you. Thank you.
In our next segment, I had the pleasure of sitting down with Veta DeMeo of the Community Development Department, who explains to us what the HARB, or Historic Architectural and Review Board, is all about. I'm here now with Veta DeMeo, the Community Development Department. Veta, thank you for sitting down with me to answer some questions again.
Thank you, Jim, for having me again.
Not a problem. Okay, Veta, so my first question for you is, what is HARB and what do they do?
HARB stands for the Historic and Architectural Review Board. They were created to protect and enhance the North Wayne District for the educational, cultural, economic, and general welfare of the public. The HARB serves to review applications for the construction, addition, or demolition of any principal building or any additions or accessory buildings.
So how often did the meetings occur and what time?
The HARB board meets the first Wednesday of every month starting at 7 p.m.
And where do the meetings take place?
The HARB meetings take place here at the Radnor Township Building in the Radnor Shire Room.
When are applications for the HARB due at the township?
All applications must be submitted to the Township Building 15 calendar days prior to the meeting. We will not accept any late applications.
So what documents are required at the time of submission?
The applicant is required to fill out an application for the HARB meeting. On the application itself, it states the requirements. Of those requirements are 7 copies of site plans drawn to scale prepared by an engineer or surveyor who must be registered in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, 7 copies of architectural plans prepared by a registered architect or engineer, including building elevations where necessary, drawn to scale, any photographs of the building under review, adjacent buildings, of structures across the street, or any buildings shown within the neighborhood are also required. These all must be in packets prepared when they're submitted to me at the township or my coworker, Marion Cassidy.
Is there a fee?
The application for a HARB, the fee is $50.
Is the applicant required to attend the meeting?
Yes, all applicants or the representative must attend the meeting.
So will HARB make a decision on the application the same night?
Yes, the HARB board will make their decision based on what is presented the same night of the meeting.
If an application gets approved the night of the meeting, does that give permission to go on with the project?
No, although the HARB board does give their approval that evening, the project then goes before the Board of Commissioners, where the Board of Commissioners make their final approval on the project and issue a certificate of appropriateness that evening. After the Board of Commissioners gives the certificate of appropriateness and their final approval, then any necessary permits would have to be applied for before any start of the project.
Well, thanks for taking the time to sit down with me again, Veta. I really appreciate it and answering all those questions.
Thanks, Jim. Always a pleasure. And if anyone else has any further information, you can either call me here at the township or go to our website at www.radnor.com.
Registration is now being taken for Radnor Recreation's most popular winter programs, Radnor Youth Basketball and Hoops Clinic. Register early. These programs fill up fast. Radnor Youth Basketball is a recreational league for boys and girls grades 3 through 12 that prides itself on developing basketball skills, sportsmanship, and self-esteem. This staple program is entering its 25th year and has developed over 20,000 young athletes in the Radnor community since 1988. Register for youth basketball before November 10th and save $20 on your player's registration. Practices begin on Saturday, December 1st. The Radnor Hoops Clinic is a unique program that creates an opportunity for players in first and second grade to learn the concepts of basketball by introducing young athletes to the game, improving their skills and developing their talent by learning basic practice drills and emphasizing the fundamentals. The program begins in early January and runs through mid-March. Volunteers are also needed to help keep this league a success. Please volunteer to be a coach, scorekeeper, or league administrator. To keep this program running, we must find great coaches willing to volunteer their time for the kids. Registration for coaches can be done at the same time as player registration or individually. Please volunteer today. To register as a player or volunteer, visit www.radnorsports.com. Do New York City your way. On Saturday, December 1st, spend the day shopping and sightseeing in New York City and leave the driving to us. We will take a deluxe motor coach to NYC and drop you off in Times Square in the middle of all the action. This is the perfect trip to get all of your holiday shopping done. Don't like shopping? Take in a Broadway show. Try the American Museum of Natural History or the Museum of Modern Art's latest exhibits. Bringing the family, maybe a visit to the Museum of Comic and Cartoon Art is in order. And don't forget to visit the Mega Toys R Us located in Times Square. This trip is one you don't want to miss. Sign up today. Seats on the bus are limited. Join us to kick off your holiday celebrations with Holiday at the Willows presented by TD Bank. On Sunday, December 9th from 2 to 4 p.m., the historic Willows Mansion is transformed with the help of a little holiday magic. The Radnor Township Girl Scouts will be on hand to make holiday-themed arts and crafts, and there will also be live entertainment, music, food, refreshments, and more. Holiday at the Willows is so popular that even Santa Claus himself stops by for a visit. Get your picture taken with Santa, and children can decorate their own frame to take the picture home in. Hope to see you there. Make sure you don't miss out on any of the excitement the Radnor Recreation Department has to offer. If you would like to receive any email announcements of our upcoming programs, special events, excursions, and other activities, please send an email to kdiamond@radnor.org to be added to our emailing list. Be the first to receive an electronic copy of our seasonal events and activities guides as they are ready, and monthly reminders of upcoming programming and events. For more information on these events and all of the Recreation and Community Programming Department's offerings, visit www.radnorrecreation.com.
And now, in our community spotlight, a short video from Saving Hallowed Ground. Finance Department is our last segment for this month. Bill White and Mary Lou Nepshield sat down to explain to us about the human resources side of Radnor Township.
All right, thanks, Jim. And this is the Finance Department segment of the November 411. So with me here today is Mary Lou Nepshield. She is making her second appearance on the Radnor 411 show to talk to us a little bit about the human resource component of the Finance Department. So thank you for joining me today.
Thank you for having me.
It's always a pleasure. How about you start off by talking a little bit about HR and what you do for the township?
Okay. Well, I do all the payroll for our 140 employees, and we also have 106 retirees that get paid on a monthly basis. Mm-hmm. And I do all of the calculations for all of the payrolls and all the taxes and all the deductions, and I also help with all of the insurance, which would be health insurance, life insurance, long-term disability. We also have a 457 plan in place.
The 457 plan is the voluntary employee deductions,
yes,
right?
That's
not something that
it's
the township...
It's sort of like the equivalent of a 401k or an IRA.
That the employees
decide. Put their own money in, and and I do all of those deductions and take care of all that. Every 2 weeks, everybody gets paid. So they'd like to see me every other Thursday. And in addition to the payroll duties, I'm also taking on more of the human resources aspect, which is the HR responsibilities are in charge of administering all the employee benefits. Mm-hmm. Notably the health insurance and the retirement plans. And then on a day-to-day basis, I answer questions from employees if they have any questions or problems regarding payroll, insurance, health claims, retirement, flexible benefit plans. And we also have wellness programs, mm-hmm. such as smoking cessation and weight loss and all kinds of things that are administered through DIVIT, who is our healthcare provider. Mm-hmm. And then on another HR factor, I help with interviewing potential employees and doing pre-employment testing and running ads. So trying to get more, we have a lot of part-time people that are working for us now, mm-hmm. in the Public Works Department. So I've placed about 6 or 7 people over there. And so it's very interesting, and everything changes on a day-to-day basis.
Oh, I'm sure. You bring up a good point about, all the administrative functions that lead up to the hiring of personnel. I know for a while the township did not have a dedicated HR person, which is one of the reasons why, as part of the reorganization back in 2011, the township created a position for HR management. One of the things, and maybe not so much for you, but the residents listening at home, one of the successes or some of the successes we've been able to achieve just by having someone dedicated to managing those benefits that you mentioned and making sure that someone is watching and auditing and making sure that what we're obligated to pay is actually what we're paying. There's been a handful of instances where discrepancies have been found. Mm-hmm. We learned that the healthcare provider was not aware of the exact benefit structure in terms of retirees, which will save the township about $130,000 over each year
annually, mm-hmm.
Moving forward. So that's not just one-time found money. That's
right.
That basically funds the department by itself. So congratulations on
Thank
that.
You.
There's not many departments that get the opportunity to say that, so you should be very proud of yourself.
Well, that's good.
Additionally, we've also found, or you've also found, with the that some life insurance policies that existed weren't, they were given but not necessarily approved, and those had to be unwound. And mm-hmm. Just these little things that add up to large amounts of money, and really it comes down to just having someone there dedicated, mm-hmm. who's watching it. So you mentioned earlier that you spend a lot of time processing payroll, which I'm sure takes a great deal of time in terms of getting timesheets into a system and then at the end of the day,
yep.
checks issued and direct deposits. I'm sure that's a lot of time. I know the township's been talking about going to an ADP system or using them to actually process. How do you think that'll help you make the transition from the payroll, you know, actually issuing the checks to more the HR side of life?
I think it will be very helpful, and it'll be a big time saver, not only on my part, but also on the part of the departments. Each department gives me timesheets every 2 weeks, and the Public Works and the Police Department have separate databases, that they put all their time into, and then they give me a report, and then I'm putting the same time into our in-house software to create the paychecks. And with the ADP system, everything will be more streamlined, and it will be coming directly through the departments directly into the ADP system. So it will eliminate the need for those auxiliary databases, and everything will all be on the same page, in other words. And I think that it will save me a lot of time, but it will also save those admins in those departments a lot of time as well. And we'll still be processing, you know, there'll still be a day every 2 weeks, I'm sure, that it will take to process, but I'm guessing that it will probably save me about 50% to 60% of my time spent on payroll. So
good.
I can go from about 3 days to one, hopefully.
And that'll be more time helping the employees out with
Absolutely.
Their issues, making
yep.
sure the open enrollment issues and healthcare are all satisfied and the
yep.
employees are...
Which we are into right now in November.
Yes.
It's that time of the year. We have a 2 or 3 week period where people can change their health insurance. They can go from the PPO to the HMO, and we have incentives for the employees to go on the less expensive insurance. They share in the savings, so to speak. And so we do encourage the employees to do that. And so hopefully we'll get some more for this year and save even more money.
That's actually a good thing that you brought that up, is that's a program that is part of, it's into the collective bargaining agreements.
Mm-hmm.
Having someone dedicated to HR means having someone out there talking to the employees,
right.
giving them all the facts.
So they have the information to make that decision.
Yes, and we've seen... I know last year we saw an uptick in the number of employees take advantage of the cost savings, which mm-hmm. we'll be sharing 50% of those savings with those employees. So at the end of the day, for the taxpayers and the employees, lower health care helps the employee out, and at the same time helps keep the township's costs low.
Absolutely.
So, well, thank you very much for taking a few minutes of your time.
You're welcome.
Help,
thank you for having me.
Help me out with the 411. So that's November. Hopefully we'll see you back here next month. Thanks.
Thanks.
Well, there you have it. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned next month for a brand new episode of Radnor 411. And remember, RTV is your information station.
We weren't born. We were born to follow. You gotta stand up.